BBC Audio presents The Archers, Ambridge Players. This collection includes six full cast productions of well-known plays, brought to you by the actors featured in The Archers.
One minute to curtain up. Remember what the master said. Speak clearly and don't bump into the furniture.
Much of a motivation, is it, Lynda?
If it's been good enough for Maggie Smith for the past 60 years, Douglas, it's good enough for you. Break a leg, everybody.
If that's all that goes wrong tonight, we'll be doing well.
Lights! And Robert, music.
Who's the master?
We present Blithe Spirit, an improbable farce by Noel Coward, with Douglas Harrington as Charles, Helen Archer as Ruth, and Fallon Rogers as Elvira. Lynda Snell is Madam Arcarty. Oliver Sterling is Dr. Bradman, and Carol Tregoran is Mrs. Bradman. Susan Carter is the maid. The play is adapted by Lynda Snell, produced by Lynda Snell, and directed by Lynda Snell. The story opens in the Condamine sitting room in Kent in the early 1940s. It is about 8 o'clock on a summer evening. There is a wood fire burning, because it is an English summer evening. I'll be seeing you
in every
That's right, Edith. Put the cocktail tray on the little table by the piano.
Yes, sir.
And turn the wireless off.
Oh.
Did you manage to get the ice out of those little tin trays?
Yes, sir. I had a bit of a struggle, though, but it's all right.
And you filled the little trays up again with water?
Yes, sir.
Very good, Edith. You're making giant strides.
Yes, sir.
And when you're serving dinner, Edith, try to remember to do it calmly and methodically.
Yes, sir.
As you're not in the Navy, it's unnecessary to do everything at the double.
Yes, sir.
No sign of the advancing hordes?
Not yet.
A dry martini, I think, didn't you?
Yes, darling. Expect Madame Arcadia will want something sweeter. I've been trying to discourage Edith from being quite so fleet of foot. You mustn't mind if everything's a little slow motion tonight.
I shall welcome it. The last few days have been extremely agitating. What do you suppose induced Agnes to leave us and go and get married?
The reason was becoming increasingly obvious.
But these days nobody thinks anything of that sort of thing. She could have popped into the cottage hospital, had it, and popped out again.
Her social life would have been seriously undermined.
We must keep Edith in the house more.
Now, you must promise not to catch my eye if I giggle. And I'm very likely to. It'll ruin everything.
You mustn't. You must be dead serious and, if possible, a little intense. We can't hurt the old girl's feelings, however funny she is. To the unseen.
Lovely. Dry as a bone. I must say, that's a wonderful title.
If this evening's a success, I shall start on the first draft tomorrow.
Used Elvira to be a help to you when you were thinking something out, I mean?
Every now and then, when she concentrated. But she didn't concentrate very often.
I do wish I'd known her.
I wonder if you'd have liked her.
I'm sure I should. She sounds enchanting.
Poor Elvira.
Does it still hurt when you think of her?
No, not really. Sometimes I almost wish it did. I feel rather guilty.
I wonder if I died before you'd grown tired of me, if you'd forget me so soon.
What a horrible thing to say.
No. I think it's interesting.
Well, to begin with, I haven't forgotten Elvira. I remember her very distinctly indeed. I remember how fascinating she was and how maddening. I remember how badly she played all games and how cross she got when she didn't win. I remember her physical attractiveness, which was tremendous, and her spiritual integrity, which was nil.
Was she more physically attractive than I am?
That is a very tiresome question, dear, and fully deserves the wrong answer.
You really are very sweet.
Thank you. Mwah.
And a little naive, too.
Why?
Because you imagine that I mind about Elvira being more physically attractive than I am.
I love you, my love.
I know you do. But not the wildest stretch of imagination could describe it as the first fine, careless rapture.
Would you like it to be?
Well, neither of us adolescent, Charles. We've neither of us led exactly prim lives, have we? And we've both been married before. careless rapture at this stage would be incongruous and embarrassing.
I hope I haven't been in any way a disappointment, my dear.
Oh, don't be so idiotic. If I died, I wonder how long it would be before you married again.
You won't die. You're not the dying sort.
Neither was Elvira.
Oh, yes, she was, now that I look back on it. She had a certain ethereal, not quite of this world quality. Nobody could call you even remotely ethereal.
Nonsense. She was of the earth, earthy.
Well, she is now, anyhow.
You know, that's the kind of observation that shocks people.
I was devoted to Elvira. We were married for 5 years. She died. I missed her very much. That was 7 years ago. I have now, with your help, my love, risen above the whole thing. Ah, that's probably the Bradmans.
Might be Madame Arcati.
No, she'll come on her bicycle. She always goes everywhere on her bicycle.
It really is very spirited of the old girl.
Shall I go, or shall we let Edith have her fling?
No, wait a minute and see what happens.
Perhaps she didn't hear.
She's probably on one knee in a pre-sprinting position waiting for cook to open the kitchen door.
Steady, Edith!
Doctor and Mrs. Bradman.
We're not late, are we? I only got back from the hospital about half an hour ago.
Of course not. Madame Arcati hasn't arrived yet.
That must have been her we passed coming down the hill. I said I thought it was.
Then she won't be long. I'm so glad you were able to come.
We've been looking forward to it. I feel really quite excited.
I guarantee that Violet will be good. I made a promise.
There wasn't any need. I'm absolutely thrilled. I've only seen Madame Arcati 2 or 3 times in the village. I mean, I've never seen her do anything at all peculiar, if you know what I mean.
Dry martini?
By all means. Oh.
She certainly is a strange woman. It was only a chance remark of the vicar's about seeing her up on the knoll on Midsummer Eve, dressed in sort of Indian robes, that made me realise that she was psychic at all.
Do you believe in it, Mrs. Condamine? Do you think there's anything really genuine about it?
I'm afraid not. But I do think it's interesting how easily people allow themselves to be deceived.
I suspect the worst, a real professional charlatan. That's what I'm hoping for, anyhow. The character I'm planning for my book must be a complete imposter. That's one of the most important factors of the whole story.
What exactly are you hoping to get from her?
Jargon, principally. A few tricks of the trade. I haven't been to a séance for years.
Do you think she tells fortunes? I love having my fortune told.
We really must all be serious, you know, and pretend that we believe implicitly. Otherwise she won't play.
Also, she might really mind. It would be cruel to upset her.
I shall be as good as gold.
Here she is.
She knows, doesn't she, about tonight? You're not going to spring it on her?
Of course. It was all arranged last week. I told her how profoundly interested I was in anything to do with the occult, and she blossomed like a rose.
Bike up against that little bush. It'll be perfectly all right if no one touches it.
Madame Arcati.
How nice of you to have come all this way.
My dear Madame Arcati.
I'm afraid I'm rather late, but I had a sudden presentiment that I was going to have a puncture, so I went back to fetch my pump, and then, of course, I didn't have a puncture at all.
Perhaps you will on the way home.
Dr. Bradman, the man with the gentle hands.
I'm delighted to see you looking so well. This is my wife.
Oh, we are old friends. We meet coming out of shops.
Would you like a cocktail?
If it's a dry martini, yes. If it's a concoction, no. Experience has taught me to be very wary of concoctions.
It is a dry martini.
How delicious. Thank you. Cheers.
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 Don't you find it very tiring, bicycling everywhere?
No, on the contrary. It stimulates me. I must say, I find bicycling very exhausting. Steady rhythm, that's what counts. Once you get the knack of it, you need never look back. On you get, and away you go.
But the hills, Madame Arcati, pushing up those awful hills.
Just knack again. Down with your head, up with your heart, and you're over the top like a flash and skimming down the other side like a dragonfly. This is the best dry martini I've had for years.
Will you have another?
Certainly. You're a very clever man. Anybody can write books, but it takes an artist to make a dry martini that's dry enough.
Oh, dinner is served, Mum.
Thank you, Edith. Shall we?
No red meat, I hope.
There's meat, but I don't think it'll be very red. Would you rather have an egg or something?
No, thank you. It's just that I make it a rule never to eat red meat before I work. It sometimes has a...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.